Hello, everybody. So I tried to do Facebook Live multiple times and was unsuccessful. So I'm just going to go ahead and create a video here and then upload it. So I hope you all are having a great Sunday. So today we're reading in Proverbs chapters 17 and 18. And a summary statement that I finally came to was using our words well. Our words matter. The content of what we say and what we listen to. Words can be used to harm or to build up. And the words of a gossip harm both the hearer and the one being talked about. And when there is an offense, words can heal or make matters worse. So ultimately, using our words well heals rather than harms others. So gossip is listed among other famous sins that we know we should not commit. And yet Christians can easily be ensnared by it. Our tendency can be to talk, to vent, or to listen to those who do. We want people to be able to empathize with us, or vice versa. But being a participant as a hearer bears judgment. Proverbs 17 verse 4 says, "A wicked person listens to malicious talk. A liar pays attention to a destructive tongue." Rather than gossiping, we can choose to cover one another. That does not mean that we do not hold each other accountable, but that we choose to see one another through the eyes of Jesus. Letting go of offenses helps gossiping or slandering to die down. The scripture of the day is out of Proverbs 17, verse 9. "Whoever conceals an offense promotes love, but whoever gossips about it separates friends." The thing about offenses is that in Christ we aren't allowed to have them. We have to forgive because we've been forgiven. Why is grace so hard for those who've received grace? Because we resort to a victim mentality and sometimes people don't apologize. And so we can be hurt. But holding on to unforgiveness hurts us truly. Don't be afraid to let go of bitterness and unforgiveness. It doesn't matter if other people deserve it. We don't either. And God forgave us anyway. But when we gossip or remain offended, we are impeding the work of God in one another's lives, and we're not about the work of God's kingdom. That's huge. One of my prayers lately has been that God would make me aware of when I might be offending others. I don't want to intentionally do so. Proverbs 17:19 says, "One who loves to offend loves strife. One who builds a high threshold invites injury." That high threshold is a wall. When we offend others or when we are offended, we create walls. God wants us to be reconciled to one another and to Him, to let go of offenses. We bite the bait of offense because of pride, self-righteousness, and hurt, but there is another way. Here's four tips to help us today. Number one, we can seek to have self-control and restrain ourselves before we speak. Proverbs 17:27 says, "The one who has knowledge restrains his words, and one who keeps a good head, a cool head, is a person of understanding. Even a fool is considered wise when he keeps silent, discerning when he seals his lips." This is challenging, y'all. This car's bouncing everywhere. Number two, we can seek to understand. A fool does not delight in understanding, but only wants to show off his opinions. When we care more for the offended than for ourselves, we have the mind and heart of Christ. We care more about redemption than getting back, even when we might be right. It isn't about being right, but about God's glory. And number three, we can choose not to participate in gossip. Proverbs 18:8 says, "A gossip's words are like choice food that goes down to one's innermost being." Jealousy, anger, and hurt are at the root of gossiping. Maybe wanting to get someone back, but all who participate in gossiping will be impacted. And finally, number four, we can release judgment and choose grace. In humility, we cannot judge another and we cannot fully understand. Proverbs 18 verse 17 says, "The first to state his case seems right until another comes and cross-examines him." When someone approaches me to talk about somebody else, I examine that person first. Why are they coming to me? It might be legitimate, but why did they not go to the other person? Let's encourage unity and restoration through Jesus. Amen. Proverbs 18:19 says, "An offended brother is harder to reach than a fortified city. Friends, when someone is offended, go after them in wisdom. It might be that we need to pray for that person because they cannot hear, but choosing to humble ourselves can win over hearts. Proverbs 18:21 says, "Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and those who love it will eat its fruit." So you guys, go with God today. Remember to choose love over an offense. And remember the four tips today. We can seek to have self-control. We can seek to understand. And we can choose to not participate in gossip. And we can release judgment and choose grace. All right, you guys, go with God, and Lord willing, we'll catch you tomorrow.